Hey, what's going on, everybody? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today I am stoked because we are going to be covering some very trendy reverse effects that you can use in your creative edits, including music videos, gaming edits, and more. I love reversing footage because it's very creative and you can get some very unique effects with it. Today we're going to be covering how to create some of your own reverse effects and combine them with things like overlays, glitch transitions, and more. This community just hit 3,000 subscribers, so shout out to everybody who's been supporting the channel. I appreciate you guys so much and I see the growth. And it's been really inspiring to meet so many of you through my Instagram. And those of you who have been downloading my packs on my website, I really, really appreciate the support. I've been wanting to put out more videos, but I've been really working hard to develop my next batch of video editing products and packs, some of which you will see in today's video tutorial. I've been working really hard on a Premiere Pro transition preset pack for you guys, as well as some brand new overlays that I think you guys are going to be excited about. So if you want to stay up to date on future video editing assets, templates, and deals, definitely consider hitting that subscribe button. So I've got some footage here in my Premiere Pro timeline of a music video that I shot 2 weeks ago, and it was a lot of fun. We shot it here in town, and we just went out to a local park and just had fun, you know, kind of hanging out, getting some of those vibey shots. And then I just kind of threw a bunch of edits on the footage. These clips here on my timeline that you see in yellow, these are gonna be areas where the reverse effects that we're gonna talk about today happen. Let's watch this first reverse effect with the music video audio.
Get tested again, the grades gonna curve in your direction. Trust I know, I ain't the first with this obsession.
So the first thing I wanna mention is this clip is filmed in 120 FPS. In order to speed that up to regular speed and synchronize it with footage, I had to speed it up to 400%. So I highly recommend that if you enjoy editing with speed, doing slow motions, reversing, fast forwarding type of effects, I highly recommend that you film your footage in 60 frames per second or 120 frames per second, because the possibilities for you to get creative are much higher when you film at a higher frame rate. So on top of this reverse effect, we have this overlay from my upcoming overlay pack. If I just change the opacity to normal, you can see what that overlay is looking like. I'm going to be dropping a bunch of these types of trendy overlays coming up here very soon. They're gonna be dropping on my website, ventervisuals.com. So with this overlay, all I did was I changed the blend mode to screen right here, and then we get some transparency, right? So now we have the overlay plus the footage underneath, and that's how we kind of get the scribble effect going on here. Now I'm gonna hide this overlay layer for now so we can just talk about the basic reverse effect here. So all this first part is I just copied this clip right here that's in full regular motion, and I reversed it. So I just hit Command R there, hit reverse speed, and I sped it up to like 2000%, right? So that's what this first part is. It's just this clip reversed, sped up to 2000, and then it cuts back to where this clip left off, right? So this clip in normal motion, I just dragged it out to about here, and then I cut it right there, and then I changed the speed back to 100 so it played in slow motion, right? So that's how we get the slow motion clip right here. We have this clip in normal speed, and then we have this clip reversing, speeding up right here to 2000, and then right here it goes back to the slow motion, and then it goes into this transition here, which is also going to be a part of an upcoming pack that I'm working on. The transitions are all going to be Adobe Premiere Pro presets. They're designed for music videos just like this. Let's watch this reverse effect with the music video audio to get a feel for what it looks like.
And beautiful things just packed tight because they fragile out. Cereal to cartoons live on the channel.
So all I did to create this reverse effect right here, let's just do this one from scratch just because. We'll just extend this clip right here. So we're dealing with the full take here. So let's just check this out without the reverse clip.
Pack tight cause they fragile out. Cereal to cartoons.
So there's no reverse clip happening there. All I did was I figured out where I wanted the reverse to start happening, and I'm gonna make a cut.
Cause they fragile out.
So right there on that kick drum right there, I think would be a really cool place for this reverse to start. So I'm gonna cut, and I'm gonna delete the second half of this clip. What I'm gonna do now is hold Option and drag this clip above itself so it's a duplicate. I'm gonna hit Command R, and I'm gonna reverse speed. This clip was shot in 60 frames per second, so I still have the slow motion capacity to slow this clip down. So I'm gonna slow it down to, let's go to 45%. right there. So you'll see it extends out now. And I'm just going to drag this first part of this clip to line up with the cut. So, and then I'm just going to drag this in right here, drag it down. So now when I scroll over, you can see he's reversing. Now, one thing to be aware of when you're doing these reverse effects is that this cut right here, sometimes you'll have a repeat frame. So you just want to make sure that there's no repeat frame when you scroll over the cut area. Otherwise, it's going to look a little janky. Obviously, right there, it doesn't have a repeat frame, so we're good. So let's check out what this is looking like so far.
Just pack tight because they fragile out.
So now we need to figure out where we want the glitch part of this transition to start happening. So I think it's going to happen right here on this kind of snap, which you can see in the audio waveform right there. So I'm going to just cut right above it and make a cut and delete the rest of this clip. I'm gonna drag our next clip out right here. And this is gonna be where we use one of my transition presets that's gonna be coming up soon on venturevisuals.com. I'm still refining the pack. So far, it's looking really cool. And I'm gonna show you guys one of my favorite glitch transitions that's in the pack as well for this. So what we're gonna do is at this cut, I'm gonna hold shift, go to the left 5 frames, make a cut right there. And then I'm gonna hold shift and go to the right twice. So now we're 5 frames over on the right. I'm gonna cut right there. Now I'm gonna right click both those clips and I'm gonna hit nest. So we're combining those two clips. Now what I'm gonna do is come over here to my effects. So what I'm gonna do is just click and drag this transition that I've created, this transition preset called Glitch Pop. I'm gonna drag it onto my nested sequence right here. And that's gonna start to give us this glitch transition. Now you'll see that it's red here on my timeline. So in order to play this back without any lag, I just have to come over here and make my in bracket hit I, and come over here and make my out bracket hit O, come up here to the very top under sequence and hit render into out. All right, let's check out what this reverse effect looks like when you combine it with a glitch transition from my upcoming preset pack.
Paddle out, and beautiful things just pack tight because they fragile out. Cereal to cartoons live on the channel down, I think.
So this last reverse transition effect is really cool because it hits on the beat drop really hard, and you can use it in a lot of different ways. We're going to be combining the reverse effect with some speed, some overlays, and some horizontal blur as well to get this very unique look. So here's the final reverse effect that we're gonna be breaking down today.
I think I'm only happy when I channel out.
So you can see that it hits right there on that kick drum. It starts to reverse right here. So we did the same thing. We took some footage, we slowed it down, we reversed it right there, and then we sped it up at the end right here. So it goes normal motion, reverse, in slow motion, then back to normal playback, and then we also are speeding it up, adding some blur and this overlay. Now this overlay is already out on my website in the texture overlays pack. If I just drag it over here to the end of my timeline, we can see what that looks like. So it's just kind of these horizontal lines that just make it look like you're going really fast, right? So I really like this overlay for these types of like speed effects right here. I think it just adds a little bit more character to the effect. So that's what we got going on here on the top. And then to get this blurry kind of background, which I think makes the motion, the speed motion, look a little bit more natural, I'm just using a Gaussian blur for that. So you can find that under your effects panel, throw that onto whatever clip you want to blur. And then I just changed it to horizontal to match the lines. So if I made this horizontal and vertical, everything would be fuzzy, but I really wanted to kind of like pull those pixels horizontally to match with this overlay. So yeah, that's how we're getting this look right here. Obviously turn the blurriness up to 120. If I turn off the Gaussian blur, you can see what a difference that makes. There's a lot of really unique ways to use reverse effects when you're editing music videos. And as you saw in this video, you can get some very creative looks when you combine reverse techniques with other things like presets, overlays, blurs, and much more. If you have any ideas for tutorials that you would like to see me do, definitely comment them below or hit me up on Instagram at VentureVisuals and shoot me a message. I've really enjoyed connecting with this community through my Instagram page, and it's the best place for me to engage with you guys one-on-one and help you guys get through any questions or problems you might have with video editing. And it's been great connecting with you guys and seeing the really cool portfolios that some of you guys have on your Instagram pages as well. If you're looking to add some sauce to your visuals today, definitely check out the free pack on venturevisuals.com. I'll include a link to that below. You can try out my overlays, transitions, and other video editing packs completely for free. And I'm really excited, guys, because the upcoming transition and overlay packs that I'm working on are fire. I've been spending a lot of time working on them, studying other people, how they create these types of digital assets, and really trying to create assets that are unique. But the overlay development and process has been really cool and satisfying to watch the packs come together. So if you're excited for the upcoming packs, definitely make sure to hit the like button down below. And I appreciate you guys for tuning in. Until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.